If you'll kindly give me your attention for a few minutes, I will tell you in a song how I became a detective. If you think for one moment that this song is cribbed from the style of Gilbert and Sullivan, you are quite right. When I was a boy, I went to school, but suffered so much from dizziness that I poked my nose as a matter of course into other people's business. I never knew my lessons, in fact, I never could begin them. I was always peeping into other boys' desks to see what there was in them. The other boys were very good boys and never used invective, but said I was only fit to be a Scotland Yard detective. I next went out in service and became a boy in buttons to a Dr. Screw who fed us all on tinned Australian muttons. He sold such heaps of medicine during closing hours on Sunday, so I opened some and found 'twas rum and got discharged on Monday. The doctor used his stethoscope in a manner most effective and said I was only fit to be a Scotland Yard detective. I next went out as footman to a man whose name was Hitchin. I found his cook carrying on with a party in the kitchen. The party she encouraged was a most conceited cockatoo. One night I found him carrying off some silver plate and a clock or two. I got him charged, and in the dock he used a strong adjective and said I was only fit to be a Scotland Yard detective. A private detective I became, but ever since I've been one, in spite of rogues and thieves at large, I've never even seen one. But as I cast my eagle eye among you gents and women all, I can't define one single sign of a downright first-class criminal. But if there is, pray give yourself up and do not be reflective. You'll get 5 years, but make the name of the Sherlock Holmes detective.